Hey guys, welcome back to The Build, where we almost never do things the right way, but we get there in the end.
I used to be lonely till I learned about living alone. I found other things to keep my mind on.
Man, I don't know how all mechanics aren't just muscular as hell, because that was an absolute workout. Maybe you're just not meant to take flywheels off with hand tools, I don't know. Bloody heavy.
Many of you watching this will already know what a BUSSO V6 is, but for the uninitiated, this engine is considered to be a fairly special engine among alpha enthusiasts. It gets its name from its designer, Giuseppe BUSSO, who was quite literally a genius. To give you an idea of how respected this guy was, during his funeral, a bunch of fans got together outside of the church and all revved up their engines in his honor. So he was very, very well respected. He started out with Ferrari and he helped design the first Ferrari engine, which went on to win Ferrari's first ever race. And upon starting at Alpha, he designed the BUSSO V6 basically in the 60s, and the engine went in production in the 70s.
And just as a testament to how good it was, it stayed in production for 26 years.
Sadly, but somewhat ironically, only a couple of days after the last BUSSO left the production line, he actually passed away in January 2006. Despite the reputation that alphas have about being unreliable, the BUSSO V6 is actually a pretty tough and well-designed engine. And it's for that reason that not only was this engine used in a hell of a lot of production cars, but it was heavily used in racing cars and it saw huge success. It's got an overly square design, which basically means that the bore, so the width of the cylinder, is actually longer than the stroke. And in practice, this gives the engine a characteristic of being really revvy and loving high revs. The other reason why this motor is so praised is the sound that it makes. And it's considered by many to be one of the best sounding, if not the best sounding, V6 ever. It has a really throaty induction sound from the front of the car, which I really love. And from the rear of the car, it's got this really raspy exhaust sound. Anyway, despite being a great engine, it's not without its flaws. And one of the theories regarding the plastic insert in the GTV6's bonnet is that it was put there to stop the plenum damaging the bonnet, because it has a bit of a nasty habit of blowing off the engine sometimes, which has actually happened to me on multiple occasions. Really though, it's a great and engaging engine, and it's just a blast to drive a car with a BUSSO V6. So this engine is a 3-litre 12-valve. It's got quite a bit more poke than the original 2.5 unit, but it's still not quite as powerful as I'd like. Now what you can do is put a BUSSO quad cam engine in your car to get a bit more power, which is basically the pinnacle version of the BUSSO. So that came in later models, and there was also a 3.2-litre variant, which would be absolutely incredible. I'm not going to go down that route. I'm just going to stick with the 3-litre 12-valve.
I bought this nice new pretty engine stand, but no matter what I do, I just cannot get it to fit onto the back there, so I might eventually get a bracket made up or something. But in the meantime, I'm just going to be a pleb and work on the floor. Every single time I work on something, I need to set up lights because it's too dark.
Yeah.
So this is the cam here, and this lobe here actuates the inlet valve directly. This lobe operates this push rod that operates the exhaust valve. As you can see, these pistons have quite a lot of carbon deposits built up on them, and they've got a little circular mark which I presume is caused by the valves. These valves are absolutely caked in crap, and the other side of their heads were even worse. This middle cylinder had so much debris in it which had fallen off the valve. It's clear that these cylinders have been burning quite a lot of oil, and when I took apart the intake system, there was quite a lot of oil in there, so it's getting into these cylinders somehow. I thought I'd make my life a little bit easier and get the block up on the workbench, and it felt really good working standing up after having sat on that floor for most of the day yesterday. I don't really know if this is the right way to take out pistons, but they all came out without too much fuss. There seem to be some small scratches on these cylinder sleeves. I certainly don't have a trained eye, but it didn't look too bad, and everything looked in reasonably good condition to me. One of the rods was much looser than the others, but it didn't seem to have caused any issues. Apart from the top of the pistons, they actually looked in reasonable condition to me, save for one which looked like it had quite a bit of corrosion on it. I can only take a guess and say that oil was blowing past that piston and then going up into the intake system and then basically being combusted in the combustion chamber and fouling everything up and burning through a hell of a lot of oil. Thanks for watching, guys. This has been the first time I've pulled apart an engine, and I'm sure I made plenty of mistakes, but it's getting rebuilt anyway, so hopefully it won't be too much of a big deal. I plan to do so much with this car in the future, rallies and track days, so hopefully join me on the journey for that. Subscribe to the channel and I'll catch you on the next one.